Good day and welcome to MT Academy. So I'm going to do another series for STPM Physics Semester 1, and we'll start with the first chapter, Physical Quantities. The learning outcome of this video is to review back what are the best quantities that we have and to learn about the dimension of those best quantities and also derived quantities. First, we look at the best quantities. So there are three things that we can describe the best quantities, which are the symbol that we use to write the formula, SI unit that we use to describe the size of those quantities, and the dimension that we are going to perform the dimensional analysis that will be discussed later on. And then we're going to explore how we can get the dimension of the derived quantities, for example, the power that you have learned in SPM. So to do this, you need to recall back the formulas that you have learned before. For example, the power is defined as the rate of energy transfer. So we have the formula of P is equal to E over T. And as for energy, let us use the formula of the work done, which has the formula of the force multiplied the displacement. And then we have F is equal to ma. And then we have the accelerations A is equal to rate of change of velocity. So now we can slowly to identify the dimension of these derived quantities. First is the accelerations that have the unit of meter per second squared. So the dimension is L per T squared. And then we're going to move up that the force is the product of the mass and the accelerations. So add another m to the dimension, which is equal to ml per t squared. And as for energy, it is the product of the force and the displacement, which is a form of length. So we have ml squared per t squared. And finally, the dimension of the power is the dimension of the E divided by t. So we have ml squared per t cubed. So based on these dimensions, we can identify the units of these derived quantities in terms of the best unit. For example, we know that the power is measured in watt, but it is also in kilogram meter squared per second cubed based on the dimension derived. And as for the energy, we know it is in joule, but also in kilogram meter squared per second squared. And as for force, it is in newton or kilogram meter per second squared. So there are a few ways to identify the units or the dimensions of the derived quantity. So you also can try yourself to identify the dimension of the other form of energy, such as the kinetic energy, gravitational potential energy, and the elastical potential energy that you have learned in SPM. So the other dimension should be the same as the energy that we have derived, which is the ml squared per t squared. So beside the derived quantities, we also have learned few constant variables in SPM. For example, the gravitational acceleration in Comfort Chapter 2. So we have learned that G is equal to W divided by M, where the weight is also a form of force that has the dimension of ML per T squared divided by M. So the dimension of G is L per T squared, which is what we have learned before, meter per second squared. And also in Form 4 Chapter 3, we also have learned about the gravitational constant, which is from the formula of F is equal to GMM divided by R squared. So rearrange the formula, you can obtain that the constant G is equal to the product of force and the square of distance divided by the product of two mass. So substitute in the dimension of each respective variables, and you should obtain that the dimension of G is equal to L cubed per T squared per M, which has the unit of meter cubed per second squared per kilogram. And then in Form 4, Chapter 4, you also have learned about the specific heat constant that has formula of Q over M theta. So the dimension of Q is the same as the dimension of energy that we discussed earlier. So it is ml squared per t squared divided by m theta. So you have the dimension of the specific heat constant as L squared per t squared per theta. In terms of unit, the specific heat constant is equal to meter squared per second squared per Kelvin. So now let's try one past questions in 2014. So the question is to determine the dimension of the derived quantity rho v squared, where rho is the density of the fluid and v is the speed. So we have learned the dimension of a speed is the length per time, so it has L per T. And as for the density, you need to recall its formula, which is the ratio of the mass to the volume. In terms of dimension, it is equal to m per L cubed. So now we can combine these two variables that we have rho v squared. So the dimension of rho is m per L cubed, and the dimension of v squared is equal to the bracket of L per t squared. So the next step is to apply what you have learned about the indices before. So in the end, you should obtain the dimension of rho v squared m per l per t squared, which the answer is v. And then we're going to try another passive question in 2013 that we have ohm is the SI unit for resistance. So now we need to find out what is the equivalent units other than ohm for resistance. So first of all, we have the formula of V equal to IR. So the resistance is equal to V divided by I. And from here, we can identify the unit as the watt per ampere, which conclude that the answer A is wrong. And then the other formula that we have for the resistance is in terms of power that we have I squared R or V squared over R. And also I've learned about the dimension of the power just now, which is the ML squared per T cubed. So what we can do next is to perform the dimension analysis to get the equivalent units. So put in the dimensions of the power and also the current, which we have ML squared per T cubed divided by I squared. So in the end, we have the unit of resistance is kilogram meter squared per second cubed per ampere squared, which the answer is C. So for answer B, we also can derive the formula to obtain the equivalent units without the dimension. So we have the energy is equal to I squared RT, where we learn about the formula of Q equal to IT. So putting in the formula that we have energy is equal to QIR. So rearrange the formula, we have the resistance is equal to the energy divided by the charge and the current. So here we can obtain the unit as joule per coulomb per ampere, which proves the answer B is wrong. So there are three ways to identify the dimension or the units of the derived quantities. I would suggest you to at least revise back the formula that you have learned in SPM, because those knowledge will be your fundamental and basic to learn about SPM physics in the next 1.5 years. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you have any interesting question you want to discuss, you can leave it in the comment section below, or you can fill in a Google form, which I will prepare in the description below. Do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.